In popular demand, today I will discuss 8 points to compare dogs versus cats. The first point is camaraderie. All pets are normally bought to be a comrade of a person. If not, they're working animals normally. So a pet needs to be a real comrade for you or your family, and what have you not. So this could be a tricky one. It all depends on what you want. Some people want a dog to come to them when they go home and greet them. Other ones want a cat that only comes to them when they want something. That's more of a cat normally. And that could be a pet or something else, but a cat thinks from its own perspective, and a dog thinks of the perspective of the master mostly. For me, this is no contest. A dog brings you so much more camaraderie that even if they live half the age of cats, or even 1/3 or a quarter, or even 10%, you get more camaraderie out of them. I will get back to this later on the life expectancy part. 2. Ease of use. This is something that is of great importance to some people and of less importance for others. But this could be that, for example, if you want to go out for the weekend and leave home at Friday and come back at Sunday evening, something like that, a cat will be a lot easier, because they have their litter box normally, and you could put some extra feed in the buckets for them and they're good to go. Also, they don't care that much when their owner leaves, because they're more fixated at the surroundings as compared to the persons. So this is something a cat wins. I must say that there are some breeds of dogs that are small enough to also be able to use the litter box, but still those dogs would be bound much more to their owner instead of their vicinity. That's one. There's another application where also the ease of use is a lot more for cats. Some dog owners really love to walk. I do as well. It also increases your health. By regular walks are good for you. You get more social interaction. You see something of nature, which I really, really love, but others really despise it. And then they rather have a litter box to clean out and just let the cats roam if they don't want to. Some people also do this. This is in most parts becoming more and more illegal, because the cats are murdering out local wildlife, especially birds. So that are the points on this topic of ease of use. The dog on a leash, in this case, is a Pettadill Terrier. He could make, this breed could make use of a litter box if you really want to, but I rather walk, which is healthy and also nicer for me to do than cleaning out the litter box every day or every other day. So keep this in mind. Look what kind of person you are. Of course, this is a sunny day. It could also be raining, could also be freezing, could also be snowing and all the other stuff. I like it, because the exposure to the elements is nice. It makes sure that you're still alive, and you can feel all those sensations, so to say, good and bad. But there are also people that really don't like it, and for me it's also good to see or start your day, for example, with some exercise like this. And walking is a very good exercise. Okay. Applicability. So what I mean here is that you can use it for a broad amount of purposes. It all depends. Where does it depend on? In general, all cats are quite natural still, in the sense that they are able to catch prey, and they can do that often a lot better than your average pet dog. But that's also their drawback. For example, if you want a cat as a pet for children, most often they are not that interested in the children. They are more interested in themselves and their surroundings. The prey drive allows you to have a pet that can also take care of rodents, but will also kill, for example, birds. You might not want the birds to go to go extinct or to be killed. It will be very hard to make the cat discriminate between that. So that's one. So cats are still more natural, which also helps in another factor we will come back later on the list. Dogs, on the other hand, if you have pet dogs or toy dogs, they're often not good at much else. Although there is one fact that normally all dogs do, and that's give you some watchdog ability. So they will alert you if something is amiss. This can be good or bad for you. If there's never ever something amiss that you want to be alerted by, they will alert you, which can be frustrating for some. For me, I would get a dog that would not bark excessively, but that's something you could look at in a later point in the list. So that's about it. But there are also dogs that you could keep as pets that are working breeds, and they are something all different to a generic pet dog. For example, if you have a working bred terrier, it will make short work of rodents much better than your average cat. Even those from the farms that they have to fend for their own living by killing animals, because they're really hard workers, and they don't do it just for themselves, they also do it for you. And you could have several types of dogs, real guardian dogs, real very speedy dogs if you are wanting a dog to accompany you when you're walking or jogging or exercising. A dog that could help you hunt, all those things you could find. Okay, this brings us to the fourth point, protection. Although there are plates that say that, look out, my cat knows karate or the likes, normally a cat wouldn't defend its family. There are also exceptions. I saw cats attack dogs, for example, when they the stray dogs went for the family. So it can be there. A cat will probably be quite dominant. They're also quite good fighters because they are more natural than dogs, and also more capable in explosive bouts. Dogs have a better stamina, but for pure protection, there's not much that you can compare with a good protection dog. And this is also an option there, and they have this naturally. Also size, the cat, if it hits you, it doesn't have that man-stopping ability that a dog can have, because dogs can be a lot larger. Okay, health. As I mentioned, normally cats are on average healthier than dogs are. Dogs have been interbred, but especially inbred, to make all those breeds. And you have so many breeds nowadays. Also, the cat breeds are climbing in varieties a lot. But you can have from the wolf the biggest dogs that go towards 100 kilograms and you have dogs of less than 1 kilograms. So 100 fold scope of just looking at the weight variety, and there are many things to consider here. So this gives you some indication. Goedemorgen. About all the differences. And that's inbreeding has deteriorated their health considerably. Also the bigger dogs especially will often don't live that long. So in general, a dog, if it's a pedigree dog, it often lives between 8 to 10 years. If you have a working breed dog, it can be a lot more, let's say 14 to 16 years. And also those mutts can sometimes survive a lot longer because of they don't have that inbreeding deficiency that much. They could be sitting in between, could be hit and miss, especially with mongrels, because it could be that a very bad parent is still being bred by for example, healthier other dog, and that could make a mongrel. Also depends how many generations they were able to survive on the street. Often they are just the first generation, and then they could be as having big problems. Also the reason that they are on the street, sometimes owners just drop them on the street because they're getting too costly. Then you get the worst of the worst. Okay, that was that point, health. Now the sixth point, life expectancy. I already mentioned in the last point. So sorry for that, I will go a little bit more in the health topic here then. Sorry, I'm just going a little bit sideways. The health topic, also hip dysplasia, and the likes are more pronounced in heavier animals. And because dogs are in general a lot heavier than cats, then this problem will be a bigger factor. Cats could have some problems also with eating. I didn't mention this yet, but this could also be the ease of use. Cat food, they are quite hard to please. They don't eat everything, and dogs will. So this, they are quite easy dogs to use. Okay, we addressed the life expectancy point now. Now the cost side, this has multiple factors. One factor could be the acquisition cost. It all depends on the dog and the cat that you're looking for. Some cats and even dogs are given for free, especially cats on the farms. If they have a farmer cat and they don't want to sterilize it, they will just be bred every now and then, and not even on purpose. If it's on purpose, they want to keep something out of it, even on the coincidental breedings of other farm cats that are living there, and they just give away the kittens for free sometimes, like rabbits. This could be very cheap. There are also some cats that are very expensive. It's not uncommon that you pay for a specific FCE registered cat with pedigree in excess of 1,000 euros, even 1,500 euros or more. Also some varieties of cats, like the Sphinx cats, are very costly. So that could give you some insight. Dogs are in general, even the pedigree ones, a little bit cheaper than the real wanted pedigree cats, but you could compare them. I think in general a cat for acquisition is a little bit cheaper because a lot of cats don't have pedigrees. A lot of dogs don't have pedigrees even, but even crossbred dogs still ask a quite hefty price tag often. So this could be a consideration there. Also the costs are of course for the food. In general, dogs are bigger, so they will eat more. On the other hand, the dog food is a lot cheaper often than the cat food. And also you could give them some scrapes. a lot of people are opposed to that, but if the scrapes are just adding to the diet to be a good supplement, I think it's better to give them some scrapes than not. I would advise to do it when you are done eating, so that the dog doesn't interrupt you during the eating and knows his place. But that could decrease the cost a lot, because you probably would throw away the scrapes anyway, and also you will diminish your output. Also, this is the case because you have less waste, not only scrapes, but also the litter box and the excrements of those kitties. Whereas by dogs, you only need your shoes will wear and tear a little bit more because of the walks, probably, and you have some sachets to put the excrements in, especially the number two when you're walking in an urban area. So that could be an additional cost. Also, dogs need to chew toys more. Both like them toys. Both will destroy them as well. I think if you buy some smart chew toys, a dog doesn't need to have more cost than a cat, because the cat often wants that lighter toys, which will often get destroyed much easier. Also, a cat often needs some additional housing, so that it can live in, and also places to put their teeth, and especially the claws on, like a scraping tool, which is also quite costly. I think the costs are quite a draw. You have to figure in the health costs as well. In general, cats are healthier, so that would normally reduce the cost per year, and it does. But the drawback is that cats live a lot longer, so the total cost of ownership is even higher with a cat. Okay, the eighth point is more a point that I mentioned along those other points a little bit. Yet there's more diversity in one animal species than the other. And for example, the cats, they now have their cats with very small legs. They have cats that are quite big, like Maine Coons. They have cats that are having no coat, like some Rex cats have. They have cats that have a little bit of dog-like behavior. For example, those Maine Coons, or even those cats that are interbred a little bit with wild cats, like savannas. So there are quite some diversifications possibilities within the cat breeds. It even crosses to wild cats yet, so some are crossing them to, for example, caracal, which is a big wild cat, etc. This also gives rise to other types of weights. So you could have a cat from 1 kilogram upwards to 20. To get to the extremes in this way, but with dogs it could be 1-2 kilogram to 100 kilogram, so a very small chihuahua or a very big molosser, for example. And it's not the only thing, they have different builds. So for example, dachshund is even shorter in legs. They have dogs that are extremely fast. They have like greyhounds. You have dogs that are able to go and enter underground. You have dogs that have a very curly coat. Terriers go underground. You have protection type of dog, molosses. You have bulldog types of dogs. There are dogs that are able to retrieve. They have a very soft bite. There are so many possibilities within the dog world, so that's easier to find the perfect pet. You could even find dogs that have a little bit the character of a cat, for example, the Basenji type of dog, which also washes itself a lot, doesn't bark, but yodels. So there's so much to choose for that. If you're healthy and you're able to go outside, some even go outside without being healthy, in their wheelchair or something like that, and it improves their health by doing so, then a dog is often the choice that can be made to work a lot easier. Whereas if you don't have a lot of time and you just want to have coincidental bumps into your pets, the cats are the perfect choice. So these were the 8 points I wanted to talk to you about. I hope you like them. If not, let me know what points that I missed. I try to give a real honest answer here without too much bias. As you know, this is my dog, so I'm a dog person more. I had a dog before as well, but before buying that dog I also had a cat. That cat was also very nice, half Maine Coon, half just a farm cat. British short hair, I think it was most closely resembling, but those that are not pedigreed, they are normally called European short hair, which I liked a lot as well. I also chose this variety to have this heterosis, the cross of two types of breeds in it, and also a farm cat is still quite able to do the things that you really want. So for example, killing of rodents, they are very good at it. Whereas the Maine Coon brings more rest and more dog-like behavior. It's also quite big in size. For me personally, if I have to choose between the two, you already guessed it, I would go for the dog. Because they are real combats, they live often a little bit less long, but they live a rich and fulfilling life, and they will give you all the love that they can, which is a big plus for me. Also, I really like that a dog, if needed, will try to protect you. So you really have an additional family member instead of something that can put up hissy fights for no reason on that one hand and could flee on the other hand at the sound of the trouble, which I don't like. I'm not saying that a cat is not brave or not courageous, because they can be. They can also be standing their ground against a much bigger type of dog, which is a sign that they are courageous. They don't go on critters. You can also fight very well for their size, so there's a benefit as well. But yeah, they just don't fit as good with my personality as a dog does. And that being said, I have friends with very nice cats. For example, a friend with a pure Maine Coon who looks just like a wolf. Perfect in any way, shape or form. And also I have a friend with two ragdoll male kittens who look perfectly, very amicable. This ragdoll type of cat is even bred to, if you pull it by the coat in the neck, then it will go limp like a ragdoll, hence the name. And it's also very big, so a very gentle type of cat. But the drawback that I see with the ragdoll, as compared to the other big cats, which is the Maine Coon. Maine Coon is quite relaxed, but the ragdoll, they say, is very little able to defend itself. And I don't like that that much, because if you put all that weight in, and also cats often go roaming around in the environment, then they will meet another cat or dog, and it would be nice if they could defend themselves if needed. They don't have to win, but they could make it a lot harder for them to be picked upon. Okay, that were my points. Have a nice day. Bye bye.